We're going to say that we're used to seeing the ideal gas law as PV equals nRT. But we should realize that we can manipulate this equation further in order to find the molar mass of a gas or the density of a gas. Here, to find the molar mass of a gas, we change it to this capital M is not molarity, it's molar mass. And remember, the units for molar mass or molecular mass are grams per mole. So we're going to say the molar mass of a gas is equal to mRT over PV. We're going to say M represents the mass of the gas in grams. And then all the other variables stay the same. So R is still our gas constant, temperature is still in Kelvin, P is still in atmospheres, and volume is still in liters. Now, if we want to find the density of a gas, we can say the density of a gas is equal to pressure times the molar mass divided by RT. Okay, so this can become our equation. We could also further manipulate, if we wanted, the second equation. We could have combined mass and volume together to give us one thing. Remember, mass over volume helps us find density. So we could have manipulated this further by saying molar mass of a gas is equal to density times RT over P. So we could have used this as well. But then again, if we have a question dealing with the density of a gas, we know we could use this one and we could just manipulate it. So even though this is a potential equation, we can get to it by just manipulating this third one. So I'd recommend just remembering these three. And if you're dealing with a question that gives you density and wants the molecular weight, you just use the third one. Manipulate it to find your answer.